You'll be off for school, huh?
Uh-huh.
You have your bus pass?
Yeah.
Boy.
What's the matter, Big Bird?
Well, some people have all the luck. Some people go off on a school bus every day and go to a school and have classes and have a lot of fun. Others get to stay here in color. Oh, I wish I could go to school.
Oh, Big Bird, don't worry. You'll be ready for school someday soon.
Oh, yeah, when? It seems like I'll never get to school.
You can come to school with me today, Big Bird. It's Visitor's Day. They said I could bring someone.
Today? Me? Now? Go to school that quick? I don't know.
If you want to come, meet me at the bus stop.
At the bus stop?
Well, terrific, Big Bird. Now you can visit school on Visitor's Day.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
perfect.
Great. Yeah.
Now nice. What's the matter?
Well, it's just that it's so sudden. I mean, I'm not so sure I really want to go. I mean, after all, I've never been to school before. I don't know anything about it. And I'll be away from home all day long. And I don't know anything yet.
Well, that's why you go to school, Big Bird. You wanted to go.
Yeah, I do, and I don't. I mean...
Well, you could try it.
Just for one day. For fun.
Yeah.
Oh, do you want me to go off to school?
Big Bird, if you feel like it...
Why not?
Oh, I get it. You don't want me around here anymore.
Oh, Big Bird, don't be silly. You know we love you.
You're our favorite friend.
Oh, boy.
Well, now what's the matter?
Well, we're just talking so much, I'm gonna miss the bus.
Oh, no. Here's a school bag.
A school bag? Can I use this?
Yes, sure.
Oh,
and here's some pencils.
Pencils, put them in.
And a notepad, a notebook.
Oh, I'll need those
here
things.
Here's an apple for the teacher.
An apple for the teacher.
Yes. Right.
But books. Kathy had books.
Books, all right. Here you are.
You want books?
Yeah, here's the books. Here's books. His books.
Oh,
all right.
Oh, okay, I better hurry.
Yes. As a matter of fact, I'll walk you to the bus
stop. Oh, boy, I'm gonna go to school.
Good luck. Have fun.
Bye.
Let's go.
Okay, but Maria, you know, I don't think the kids are gonna like me.
Oh, they're gonna love you.
No, but maybe they'll think I'm too tall or something.
No, that won't matter.
I don't know any of the kids.
Well, you're gonna meet a lot of kids.
But.
Hi.
Hi, Kathy. I'm here. I got a bag and.
He's gonna visit with you today, okay?
Oh, boy.
Oh,
here comes the bus.
Yep.
Oh, boy, I hope it's gonna be all right.
All right, Big Bird, here's some money.
Oh.
I'll just put it in your bag, okay?
Oh, thank you, Maria.
This is for lunch, and there's some fare money in there.
Well, do I have to get on now?
Yes.
Oh, Maria?
Huh?
You'll be here when I come back?
Oh, of course I will, Big Bird.
Oh, thanks, Maria.
Hurry up.
Okay, whoops. Let me... Bye!
Do you go through this every morning?
What's it like to be in school? Is it fun? Is it cool? Are there lots and lots of rules? What's it like to be in school? Tell me, what is school about? Can I laugh? Can I shout? Is it inside? Is it out? Tell me, what's it all about? What's it like to be in school? Will there be a teacher who'll help me out when I'm new? What's it like to be in school?
Bye.
What's it like to be in school? Is it fun? Is it cool? Are there lots and lots of rules? What's it like to be in school? Tell me, what is school about? Can I laugh? Can I shout? Is it inside? Is it out? Tell me, what's it all about? What's it like to be in school? Will there be a teacher who'll help me out when I'm new? What's it like to be in school?
E, E, C, me. Eating a peach, sitting on my eagle, chasing a beagle, to the queen on her knee, under a tree, by the sea. She was looking for her Easter egg. Having a dream about eating ice cream in the land of steam. When a baby seal tickled her heel, she let out a squeal. And woke from her dream in time to see the eagle and me flying away with the Easter egg over the evening sea.
Do you know what signing is? Signing is a way of talking used by people who can't hear, who are deaf. Linda is signing because Linda's deaf. Now Linda's going to sign the word sing. Then we're going to play a game. I'm going to do a song with the word sing in it. And every time you hear it, sign the word. Sign sing. I'll do it with you, okay? Sing. Remember, every time you hear it, sing. Sing. Sing a song. Sing out loud. Sing out. Not bad. Sing of happy, not sad. Sing, sing a song. Make it simple to last your whole life long. Don't worry that it's not good enough. Just sing, sing a song. La 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 la. Sing.
Very good.
So, the key for us to be my viva is that not if I buy, nothing can move me!
Ocean gets rough when there's a storm. When the rain stops, I like to go exploring on the rocks. Maybe I'll find some interesting things today. Sometimes I find something unusual. I like to find things that get washed up on the shore. Like seaweed shells and crabs. I like the sound of walking on the sand after a storm. You can see your own footprints in the sand. The birds leave their footprints too.
Missing Kathy, okay.
Good morning, Mrs. Merkel.
Wow. So this is where it all happens, huh, Kathy? The school, the big school.
Hello.
Mrs. Merkel, this is my friend Big Bird. He's my visitor. Can he sit in class today?
Yeah, please. Maria said to give you this apple.
We've never had a bird in class before.
Oh, well, you won't even know I'm here.
I won't, huh?
Mm-mm.
Well, sure. Why not? Come on.
Oh, boy.
Let's turn down this way.
Okay.
Big Bird, this will be your desk.
This one?
Yes.
This is my very own desk?
Give me your bag.
Oh, boy. My very own desk.
Okay, better settle down now. Class starts soon.
Oh, boy. It's all one piece. Well, I'll just sit on my desk. That's not too good. Well, I know, I'll just sit in the desk. It's so little. I could sit under the desk. That's not too good. Oh, dear. Mrs. Merkel!
What's the matter, Big Bird?
Oh, well, I can't sit on my desk, I can't sit in my desk, and I can't even sit under the desk. What am I gonna do?
Why don't you sit next to your desk?
Next to my desk? Oh, what a good idea. Oh, this is wonderful. You know, you're very smart. You're probably as smart as the teacher.
I am the teacher.
Oh.
The ball goes up, the ball goes down, the ball keeps going round and round. I'll catch you, throw heads up, follow. The ball goes up, the ball goes down, the ball keeps going round and round. I'll catch you, throw heads up, follow. The ball goes up, the ball goes down, the ball keeps going, the ground goes down. The ball keeps going, the ground goes down. The ball keeps going, round and round.
Gotta brush brush my pearly whites so they don't lose their bite. And when I swim downstream, I make those other fishes scream. They'll jump with the light, with the light, at the sight of my white, bright, clean of and clean, I mean, perfectly pearl white teeth. They're the key to my success. I'm the king of toothsomeness. All the little fish beside me tried to hide, but when they spot me, they were stunned. Oh, happiness, they were stunned by the sight of my white, bright, longer than long, strong, perfectly pearl white teeth. By the sight of my white, bright, longer than long, strong, perfectly pearl. Couldn't you just eat me up?
All right, class. Let's see who can answer some questions. I have some pictures here. This is a grasshopper. This is a bee. And this one's a spider. Okay? Now, which insect makes honey?
I know.
A big bird. In school, if you want to talk, you raise your hand. You see, if everybody talks at the same time, I can't hear anybody.
Oh.
So if you raise your hand, you'll get your turn.
I get it. Mum's the word. Say no more. From now on, this bird will raise his wing.
Good. Okay. Which insect makes honey? Kathy?
Bees make honey.
Good. Which one spins a web? Nico?
A spider.
Very good. Now, which one has long legs and hops around? Big Bird. Which one has long legs and hops?
Oh, I don't know.
Well, why'd you raise your hand?
Well, I was just practicing hand raising. I mean, do you think I should raise high like this or swing it around more?
That's very good. It's very good, Big Bird.
Gosh, you learn to raise your hand. You get your turn. Wow, am I learning lots of things in school today?
Oh, Birdo, buddy, we're all ready to paint. This is going to be so great.
I don't know. I'm not so sure about that, Ernie.
Well, why, Bird?
Well, Ernie, because we only have one canvas and an easel, and and you have only one brush, and one set of paints.
One set of paints? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well, no problem, Bert. We'll share.
Share?
Sure. See, you can use the canvas and easel over there, and I'll use the paints and the paintbrush. Hmm? How about that?
There
we go.
Mm-hmm. Well.
Do-do-do-do.
But.
Mm-hmm. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do.
Ernie, what are you doing?
Well, you see, I am painting a fire engine that's coming to the rescue of this little kitty cat that's up on the top of the tree here. See the little kitty cat in the green tree, and see the little blossoms on the tree, and this isn't working, is it, Bert?
No, I mean, that's a fun way to paint, Ernie, but it's just not what I had planned on, you know? I don't know, I can't paint without painting a brush, and you can't paint without something to paint on, so I guess I'll just go do something else.
Hey, wait a second, Bert.
What?
Hey, Bert, I have another idea.
What?
Well, see, I know how we can paint together. See, you could tell me what to paint, and I'll do it.
Yeah.
And then I'll decide what to paint, and then you can do it. How about that?
Oh, okay, yeah, yeah.
See, we can cooperate.
Cooperate, yeah,
yes.
Okay.
Okay, here, Bert, you can paint first.
No, I thought you go ahead and paint, and I'll try and think of something to paint, okay? You just,
okay.
I'll think of
okay.
something.
Okay.
Let me see. What can we paint? What can you paint, and I can think of it.
How about a jungle, Bert?
Well,
a jungle with a great big purple monster in the jungle, Bert. How about that?
No, I'm thinking, wait,
okay.
I got it!
Okay.
Wait, I got it. Really,
what?
Something really exciting.
Mm-hmm.
You ready?
Mm-hmm.
A bowl of oatmeal.
Hey, Bert, how about we do a big purple monster eating a bowl of oatmeal?
Hey, yeah, all right, good, that's a deal,
okay,
yeah.
Okay, all right, here we go.
Okay, terrific.
Mm-hmm.
Don't use too much blue there.
Okay.
I like my oatmeal looking real nice and gray. Oh, that's terrific.
8.
All right, class. Let's count to 20.
Mrs. Miracle?
Yes, Big Bird?
May I count too?
Certainly, if you know how.
Do I know how? They don't call me old Mr. 1, 2, 3 for nothing. She doesn't know it, but I can count all the way up to 10.
Ready to count, class?
Yes. Yes.
Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Very good.
Mrs. Miracle?
Yes, Big Bird?
How come they kept counting? Why didn't they just stop at number 10 like I did?
Because we were counting to 20.
You mean it's possible to count all the way up to 20? The big 20?
Certainly. You can count to 50, 100, 1,000.
Oh, I didn't know that. All I can do is count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Big Bird, that's very good.
It is?
10, and you're not even in school yet.
Oh, yeah.
You can be very proud.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Ah.
Where did you learn how to count to 10?
On Sesame Street.
Oh.
Do you want to hear my alphabet?
There are all kinds of thoughts. Here's a repetitious one.
It, it, it. It, it, it.
Think repetitiously.
Imagine.
Get down, get funky with your bad self. The music's old, but hey, it's
go.
Gonna put my right shoe right on.
Right on.
My left shoe right on.
Right on.
The TV right on.
Right on.
Gonna put the kettle of tea right on. Gonna make a right on the corner of Main Street. Gonna be right on time for the track meet. Got all the answers right on the test I took. I left all my money right on top of that book. I'll go right.
Keep on grooving with Nagi.
All righty, here's the rest of Sesame Street Unpaved on Nugget. Groovy.
That's very good, Telly.
Oh, well, thank you.
You play the tuba well.
Yeah, well, it's just a hobby. But that tune, it's a beautiful one. Could you play it with me?
You want me to back you up?
Or would you?
Oh, sure, I'd love to. What part do I play?
Well, you don't mind accompanying me?
No.
Okay. Sure. Well, Mr. Perlman, you take the high part, and I'll take the low part, all right?
Okay.
Now, I should warn you that the low part is the fun part.
Oh.
Do you still want to play with me?
I don't mind. I'd love to.
Okay.
Okay.
You count it down.
Okay. You ready?
Yes.
Okay, great. Okay, here we go.
Thank you.
Gee, Kathy, how come we left the classroom when we're out here in the hallway? Is school over?
No, between classes, we can leave the school and do things like get a drink of water or go to the bathroom. It's called recess.
Recess. Recess. Now, that's part of school I'm going to try to do really good. So I think the first thing I'll do during recess is get a drink of water. I'm waiting. Come on, water. What's the matter? Why aren't you coming up here? Come on, I want a drink. Kathy, I'm afraid the water fountain's broken. Nothing's happening.
You have to push the button.
I have to push it. Oh. Oh, like that. Pretty good. And you know what? I wasn't even thirsty. Now for the other part. Where's the bathroom?
This is the girls' room and this is the boys' room.
Okay. That's the girls' room and that's the boys' room and... But not the girls' room. No, Oh. Mrs. Merkel! Mrs. Merkel! Mrs. Merkel!
What's the matter, Big Bird? Keep it down in the hallway.
Oh, I'm sorry, but if that's the boys' room and that's the girls' room, then where's the birds' room?
The birds' room?
And now, the star of daytime television, your host for the Mystery Mix-Up Game, Guy Smiley!
From our studio audience, this is Altoona Rooney from Fishville, Mississippi. Come on out here, Mrs. Rooney. Wonderful. Yes, it's you. Wonderful, Mrs. Rooney. Tell me, are you excited about playing today's game?
Yes.
All right, Mrs. Rooney, let's find out all what wonderful prizes you're going to win if you win.
Prizes!
Mrs. Rooney, if you can solve today's mystery mix-up, all these fabulous prizes are yours.
Yes.
4 fabulous flowers from Fliegel the Florist. This terrific GTZ TV. A remarkable refrigerator by Cool and Company. Surprise package from Freddy Fink's Fabulous Furriers. A handsome vacuum cleaner by the Hoodwink Vacuum Cleaner Company. A stand-up, sit-down, fully automatic oven range by Rufus Ranges. This genuine plastic lawnmower by Dream Machine. A wonderful milk machine by Golden Guernsey.
It's a cow!
Add to these gifts this grand prize piano by Pulitzer.
Oh,
back to you, Guy.
All right, Mrs. Rooney. All you have to do to win these wonderful prizes is go to our mystery mix-up board back there, and you're going to have to take all those things that are mixed up and put them in the right order. But first, let us find out at home what our mystery mix-up puzzle is.
Today's mystery mix-up is the word school. School.
All right, Mrs. Rooney, are you ready?
Yes.
On your mark, get set, go!
Let's see. Maybe the S would go up
okay,
over here.
Okay, she has the
that
S.
Nice.
Maybe the S.
I think the C would look
all right,
very
now
nice
she has
next
the
to the S. And,
S-C.
Maybe the H would look pretty right next
now
to the
she's
C.
She's got the H.
And,
S-C-H.
Oh, maybe
let's
an
see,
O would look very next to the
all right,
very
she's
nice
got an O. She's got an O.
Maybe another O would add texture to the other
she's
O.
She's got the other
Oops,
O.
Oops, that one got it dropped off.
The first O is back in place.
Oh, the L
one more letter.
And school. Next to the
she has
O there. And,
but now
the flower pot looks very nice over here.
Putting
yes.
On the other side of the
and,
television
maybe the whole thing
and now she's got the television
the
set and the flowers. And she's
oh,
putting
the cow,
them
but maybe,
over
whoops,
by the cow.
The flower pot looks lovely
now,
down there. You put
she's
your whole foot in
cow.
There. And then,
she's
oh,
moving the
and
cow.
That's it for today. Thank you for being with us, and be sure to tune in next time for the Mystery Mix-Up Game.
Wait a minute.
What's the matter?
I'm trying to remember something here. It starts with the letter F.
F, huh? Let me think. Was it feather?
No, it wasn't.
Flower?
I don't believe so, no.
Fish?
No, it couldn't have been fish.
Fig?
No.
Fern? Fork? Food?
No.
A fizz?
No.
How about fudge?
No, thanks. Couldn't touch another bite. No, it wasn't fudge.
A finger?
No.
Fur?
No.
Fin?
No.
Flag? Or maybe...
Wait a minute. Hold up. I remember now.
Well, what is it? Tell me.
Finished.
Funny.
Now, Big Bird, can you read for me what's up there over the blackboard?
You mean those letters up there?
Yep.
Well, I bet I could.
Good.
Where should I start?
Why don't you try that end?
Oh, okay. Well, it starts here. It says, Abkadefgi Jekomenop Quer Stuvrixes. Ooh, that's a long word.
Bird, it's not, you see.
Oh, well, I'll bet you want me to guess what that word means, huh?
No, Big Bird, it's...
Well, no, let me guess. I bet I can figure this out.
Abkadefgi Jekomenop Quer Stuvrixes. It's the most remarkable word I've ever seen. Abkadefgi Jekomenop Quer Stuvrixes. I wish I knew exactly what I mean. It starts out like an A word, as anyone can see. But somewhere in the middle, it gets awfully queer to me. Abkadefgi Jekomenop Quer Stuvrixes. If I ever find out just what this word can mean, I'll be the smartest bird the world has ever seen. Maybe Gordon would know, or maybe Bob. I could ask them. Then again, it might be kind of an elephant, or a funny kind of kazoo, or a strange exotic turtle that you never see in a zoo. It might be a kind of doggy, or a particular shade of blue, or maybe a pretty flower. Nah, not with a name like that. Abkadefgi Jekomenop Quer Stuvrixes. It's the most remarkable word I've ever seen. Abkadefgi Jekomenop Quer Stuvrixes. I sure wish I knew exactly what I mean. It starts out like an A word, as anyone can see. But somewhere in the middle, it gets awfully queer to me. Abkadefgi Jekomenop Quer Stuvrixes. If I ever find out just what this word can mean, I'd be the smartest bird this world has ever seen.
But you know, I give up. What does that word mean?
Okay, Klaus, what are these letters? This is a what?
Alphabet!
That's right.
Alphabet. Ah, well, have I learned something today?
What have you learned today?
Well, I've learned that Abkadefgi Jekomenop Quer Stuvrixes and the alphabet are both spelled the same way.
This is the small letter F, and it makes a sound like is the first sound in the word flower. Is also the first sound in the word forest. Can the fast fox find the flower that grows in the forest? He went too far. Poor fellow. His friend, the fat frog, finally found the flower.
Fantastic.
Woo-wee! I tell you, there's nothing like sleeping out here under the moon and the big sky, forgetful.
You can say that again, Clementine. But right now I'm going to sleep.
Hold it, forgetful. You can't go to sleep yet. There's something you're forgetting to do.
Me? Why, I never forget anything, Clementine.
Oh, yes, you do, Forgetful. That's why they call you Forgetful Jones, because you forget all.
Oh, yeah. I forgot.
And what you're forgetting to do now is real important to do before you hit the sack.
It is.
It sure is. Something you have to clean, forgetful.
Oh, the dishes, right?
No, you already did the dishes.
I already did the dishes.
Yeah, I'm talking about teeth. And you need to use this, forgetful. What is it, forgetful?
Oh, I know what that is. That's whatchamacallit.
Toothbrush, forgetful. This is a toothbrush.
Right, a toothbrush. I remember now, Clementine. Before I go to bed, have to brush Buster's teeth.
Forgetful.
Get the toothbrush out here.
Forgetful. What about your teeth?
My teeth? Oh, yeah. Well, but I can't brush my teeth and Buster's teeth. So why don't you, Buster, brush my teeth and I'll brush your teeth? Okay?
Okay, we'll cooperate then.
Good.
Okay.
All right, open up here.
Okay. You open up too?
Yeah. There we go. Oh. Don't forget them molars.
Okay.
All right. Oh, yeah.
That's my forgetful.
Teeth twice a day, and you'll end up with a terrific smile.
Gee. I don't know any of the kids here. I don't know anybody except Kathy. I don't know. On Sesame Street, I know all the kids. But here, it's really different. I'm a stranger here. Gosh, and those kids look like they're having fun, too. Wish I could join them, but they don't even know me. Wonder how I could make friends. I could go over to them and tell them my name and ask them their name. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. Still, what if they laugh? They don't know me. Maybe I better practice first. Yeah, I could use this wastebasket and pretend that it's a kid. And I'll practice on this. Okay, you be a kid, and I'll try it on you. Hello, I'm Big Bird. What's your name? My name is Big Bird. What's your name? Is it Joe or Louise? If you know, tell me please. I would like to be your friend. We could play a game. What's your name? Maybe you're a Henry, Mary, Beth, or Faye, Lisa, John, or Dulcie, Emily, or Ray, Judy, Sarah, Norman, Angel, or Jose. Well, even if it's Murgatroyd, I like you anyway. Hello, I'm Big Bird, what's your name? My name is Big Bird.
what's your name? I am tall, I can run, I play ball, I am fun, and I would like to be your friend. I hope you feel the same. What's your name?
I'm gonna try it. Hi, kids. I'm Big Bird. What's your name?
Alice.
Hi, Alice.
Ricky.
Hi, Ricky.
Vivian.
Hi, Tony. Nico.
Vivian.
Hi, Vivian.
Peter.
Hi, Peter. Hi, Jana. Hi. Gosh, I'm a bird. Can you do this?
Would you like to play jacks with us?
Oh, I'd love to play jacks. Did you see that? It worked. It worked.
Gonna paint an 8.
I know, Miss Merkel, but say, how did I do?
Very well. You're a very good student. Oh. But I think you better go catch your bus.
Oh, I will. Just as soon as I do this. You know, I think this is nailed to the floor.
Big Bird, what are you doing?
Well, you said it was my desk, right?
Well, yes.
Well, since it's my desk, I just thought I'd take it home with me.
Big Bird, it's only yours while you're in school.
Oh, not even to take home as a souvenir?
No, but when you come back to school every day, and you will, it'll be waiting here for you.
Oh, okay. Easy come, easy go. Goodbye, desk. You know, it was too heavy anyway.
saxophone.
Hello, my name is Olga, and I am a very lonesome robot. But with these robot parts, I am going to build another robot exactly like me. Then I won't be lonesome anymore. Isn't this pretty? Something tells me one of these parts does not belong. I'll find out which one. Dum-dee-dum. Oh, a nice part. Dum-dee-dum. Something is not quite right. Better try again. Dum-dee-dum. Huh. Something is still not right.
Excuse me. Has anyone seen my hat? Oh, there it is. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Here they come. I hope Big Bird had a nice time at school.
Yes, he was so worried. He didn't think he'd make any friends.
I hope he made some. Hi, Kathy. Where's Big Bird?
In the bus.
Big Bird, you're home. Get off the bus.
I have to say goodbye to my friends. Goodbye, Rob. Bye, Sonia. Bye, Debbie, Dulcie, Sharon. Goodbye, Lou. Goodbye, Joe, Mike. Bye, Emily. Goodbye, Chuck.
Well, Big Bird, how was your first day at school, huh?
Oh, it was really exciting.
Yeah?
Oh, we did all kinds of exciting things, and I even was allowed to use the chalk on the blackboard. I was really good at recesses, and look what I made in woodworking.
Oh, Big Bird, I love it.
Yeah?
What is it?
Well, it's a bookend, I think. Oh, but school was really great.
Uh-huh.
You should have been there.
Well, tell me
I gave
all
that
about
apple
it.
To
you
the teacher.
Did she like
oh,
it?
Oh, she liked it.
Oh, she's pretty.
Oh, yes,
yeah.
Very nice. Oh, I met a lot of friends. I knew I could.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters E and F. And by the number 8. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.